We're at the High Voltage Engineering Laboratory at the Indian Institute of Science, and we are here to look at a very interesting piece of technology. Before we do that, we're going to talk to Mr. Subrotim, and can I even call you Mr.? Should I call you Master like they do in those Bollywood films? Anyway, this is Saad, and they're going to tell us a little bit about Ati Motors. First of all, it's a very interesting name. So tell me about this name and then tell me about what the company does.
Okay. So Ati means superlative in Sanskrit.
Yeah. Okay. So tell a little bit about what you guys are doing here.
So we are developing an autonomous electric cargo vehicle.
Right.
For use in basically industrial environments. We can move cargo both indoors and outdoors.
Okay.
Within private spaces.
Right.
So we want to be able to carry 150 kilograms on the vehicle itself.
Right.
And we also want to be able to carry loads and trailers,
right,
up to 500 kilograms.
Okay.
So basically in the sub-ton category.
Right. So let's not waste any more time. Let's just show you how the vehicle works. And for that we have Kamlesh here, who will be operating the vehicle. And there you go. Let's see.
Yeah. So the vehicle has three wheels, two front wheels that drive. Each of the motors in the front can run at different RPMs, and that's how we turn. It's
right.
called a differential drive system.
Right.
And the rear wheel is just to steer in the same angle that the front wheels drive it at.
Okay.
As you just saw, Saurabh stood in front of the vehicle.
Mm.
The lidar detected him as an obstacle. He's doing it again.
Yeah. So it won't
it
collide.
Stops.
It won't collide.
It will not collide with a person standing in front of it.
Right.
And it continues on after the obstacle is gone.
Right.
And now it's reached its
destination
and it'll wait for the user to end the trip.
Okay.
So now it's going to the start point for the trip. And basically this is the point where you load stuff onto a vehicle and then say start trip.
And yeah. and what he said just now about the user interface, anyone being able to operate it?
Yeah, it's fairly simple. So it's so we basically have a trip-based model.
Right.
It's just like
an Uber for
it's
cargo.
It's like an Uber for cargo.
Right. So why does the vehicle have to do a full turn to go back to the starting point? Why cannot go by the same route, by the same route that it came?
So basically, some of these roads are marked as one way.
Right.
So it can only move in this direction on this road. So it has, and it also knows that this road is all, you can move in this direction. So
right.
there's a shorter path instead of going all the way around here.
Okay. Oh.
It does an in-place turn here
right.
to fix its rotation.
Right.
So because of our three-wheel design,
right.
it's actually a differential drive on the front two wheels, so we can
right.
actually do a zero turning radius turn right. around the center of the vehicle.
So whatever happens, it should avoid going over the yellow lines.
Yes, right. it would.
Right.
So basically, one of the requirements we have is before we enter a new environment, we do a mapping run.
Hmm.
Where you basically collect all the map and details about the lanes and bits
right.
and stuff.
So. Right. Okay. What do you envision are the applications for this vehicle? In what areas can it be used? And also, are there any industries that are currently using it right now in their factories?
So, right now, our primary use case is material movement inside industrial environments. So you can imagine factories or factory complexes.
Right.
And I don't, nobody's, at least in India, nobody's using autonomous vehicles inside the factories. Some people use AGVs,
mm.
but they're much simpler. They can only move on fixed routes.
Mm.
So basically they assume that the environment is going to be instrumented for their operation.
Mm. Okay.
And they can handle intersections.
Right. And are there any industry that are using this, this particular vehicle that you built?
So we've done demos on site at quite a few factories.
Right. And how have they gone?
Pretty well.
Right. So you're confident that the vehicle can be used by different companies. Okay. So tell me a little bit about this vehicle. How do you actually get it to run? What technologies are used in it?
So the vehicle has been designed from ground up for autonomy, so it's a mechanically very simple. It's a three-wheel vehicle with two independent motors driving the front wheels. So it's turned. So we turn it using a differential drive. So one of the wheels goes slow and one of them goes faster and the vehicle turns.
Right.
The rear wheel is effectively behaves like an active caster wheel. So we calculate what angle it must be at for the turn and then we just...
So for example, if you want to turn left, then the left wheel will run at a slower RPM than the right wheel. Hence causing the vehicle to steer left.
Right.
And the rear wheel will just match the angle that the front wheels make and it will complete the turn.
Right.
And there are two motors in this, I believe.
Yeah. So there are two brushless DC motors.
Right.
So we have 2 3-kilowatt motors for the front.
Okay. And what about the battery?
We have a 8-kilowatt-hour battery.
Right.
And what's the top speed that this vehicle can travel at?
So in most industrial environments, speed regulations don't let you operate more than, let's say, 3 to 4 meters per second.
And
in most and most operating environments, you'd probably see speeds around 1 to 1.5 meters per second.
Okay. And I presume you charge it, the vehicle. What's the charging time like?
So on this prototype, it takes 2 hours to fully charge the battery.
Right.
So in our next variant, we actually have a battery swap capability. So you don't have to wait for a battery to be fully charged. As soon as you run out, you just swap it out for another battery.
Okay. So what sensors does it use to avoid obstacles in its path and to navigate these routes?
So we have a couple of sensors on the vehicle. So we have a LiDAR, we have a camera, we have an IMU, which is basically an accelerometer plus gyroscope, and wheel encoders.
Right.
So our autonomy stack fuses input from all these sensors for localization. So we need to know once you've in the environment, where are we?
Right.
We also detect obstacles around us, and then that feeds into our autonomy stack, and that's pretty much how we.
Right. So tell me a bit about the about your use of LiDAR, because it's a fairly new technology and it's quite groundbreaking.
Yeah, we can see where something is and get its exact coordinates.
So essentially, this LiDAR has 16 beams that are projected out, and it is rotating, so it sees all 360 degrees around it. It gets hits from obstacles around it. And it can get the distance of each obstacle using
So every second we get hundreds of thousands of points from the LiDAR.
So hits and an obstacle, bounces back.
Yeah, and so essentially we can reconstruct this entire scene, a 3D
on
map.
On your computer.
On our computer, and we know where we are and we can.
So you can build a high quality HD map of the environment.
Right.
So my final question is about the load carrying capacity. How much can this, how much cargo can this vehicle carry?
So this variant can carry 150 kgs and tow additional 350 kgs.
Okay, so it's quite practical for use in companies and so on. So I imagine a lot of companies are really excited to use this vehicle. When can we see your production ready version?
Within this year.
Oh, great. So by the end of the year, you think you'll be able to launch?
Yeah.
Okay, or before the end of the year?
Yeah.
Okay, that's fantastic. So that'd be great. We're really excited to see this in action and it would be great to have it all over India. So congratulations and keep doing this great work. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
Thanks.